So responsible consumption of electronic products and citizens' duty are two keys to solve the e-waste pollution. If citizens start realizing that giving their electronic waste to kabadiwalas is hazardous, and for them as well as for the environment, then they shall use the easy pathway for disposal. And that is what ewasteexchange.com is.
Hello and welcome to the Mission Shunya podcast. I am Girish Shivakumar. Hope you've been enjoying the podcast so far. It feels really good to receive feedback from listeners from around the world. Your feedback definitely helps me make the podcast better. Special thanks to all the listeners who have given this podcast a rating and wrote a review on Apple Podcasts and iTunes. Ratings and reviews on the Apple platform really help in the discoverability of the podcast. So big thanks to all of you. And after I spoke about the social media pages of Mission Shunya, I have seen a lot of engagements in the social media channels. So special thanks to all the people who have liked the page on Facebook or followed me on Twitter or Instagram. Let's keep the conversation going online as well. So this week's topic, like I said in the previous episode, is going to be about electronic waste. Every year, you would probably replace an electronic appliance from your home. It could be probably a phone, television, laptop, or so on. But little do you realize that throwing away your existing gadget is actually hazardous to both the environment and your health. So on this episode, the guest is...
I'm Dr. Shalini Sharma. I'm a co-founder and CEO of Sanshodhan and e-waste exchange.
Can you briefly tell about your work that you've done so far and what do you do?
Though I do lead another organization that's called as Institute for Circular Economy and Sustainable Development Goals, with around 15 years of experience on environment management and policy, we initiated this organization around 1.5 years back. So at present, I'm leading Sanshodhan e-waste exchange and working for the electronic waste management as well as plastic waste management from Hyderabad, India. But of course, for businesses, we operate pan-India.
Fantastic. That is precisely why I wanted you to be part of the podcast, because I would like to know, like, how much e-waste does India generate in a year and how does India stack up against the world?
So according to the official data of year 2017, India produces about 2 million tons of electronic waste per annum. And worldwide, it is around 45 million metric tons of electronic waste. And it's increasing approximately 15 to 18% per annum. But of course, India is a fast developing economy and purchase power is quite high, as well as the population is quite tech savvy here in India. Thus, India is quite big market for electronic manufacturers, and it's very much possible that electronic waste generation in India is increasing at the rate of 25 to 30% per annum.
But handling e-waste is not something new. I'm sure developed countries are handling e-waste in a better way. So how are developed countries in general handling e-waste?
So about 66 to 67% of world population, especially from the developed countries, are having electronic waste management regulations in place. Of course, manufacturers lobby on the one side and informal recyclers on the other side makes the implementation a little bit difficult. And moreover, scenario is same worldwide. In developed countries, electronic waste management, or in fact, any waste management, is all supported by the government in terms of funding, in terms of technology, and absorption of means, and easy to strengthen the implementation of regulations. They also depend a lot on exports. So export of electronic waste and hazardous waste from developed country to developing country or least developed countries has been their major strategy, which is, of course, a matter of global concern now. It is a crucial time, and all countries need to join hands to deal with the electronic waste and associated plastic waste, which is, of course, carcinogenic if burnt openly.
Waste management is definitely a global problem, especially the electronic waste. Developed countries shipping their waste to the developing world has been going on for a long, long time. In the recent years, developed countries have been shipping waste to one country in particular, China. But the recent regulation in China mandates that all the waste that comes to China has to be properly segregated, and only then China will recycle them. So this mandate has made sure that China accepts only clean waste that is segregated and which it can recycle. India, as Shalini mentioned, has been accumulating e-waste by around 25-30% per year. So what is India really doing to handle the electronic waste that it generates? Here is Shalini.
So India initially, first they made e-waste management rules in 2011. But nobody really bothered about it. So from 2011 to 2016, nothing happened in this field. In March 2016, somewhere, Government of India initiated the implementation or released the e-waste management rules. But there were a lot of discussions among industries and government, and the way the Government of India really wanted to implement the e-waste management regulations has not happened. Then industry lobby, they informed the government that they are still not ready for the implementation. That's why still industry need to be given some time. And from year 2016, the implementation or enforcement of e-waste management regulations was shifted or postponed to September 2017. But from September 2017, it was really enforced. But that was not all. The first version of e-waste management rules was not all. Amendments kept pouring in. So new e-waste management rules and amendments 2018 were implemented in or came in the picture from in March and again in May 2018. So manufacturers, lobbies and recycling associations are for imports. Which is, of course, in long term is not good for the implementation of regulations, as well as for the social, environmental and economic health of our country. E-waste management regulations in India, they mandated the implementation of extended producer responsibility targets that are for the electronic product manufacturers. Though the e-waste management rules, electronic product manufacturers also provided with the provision of e-waste exchange and PRO to support them for meeting the EPR targets. But it's not really providing a holistic picture at present. If you see, the e-waste management regulations in India are in place, but the audit mechanism is not. Thus, EPR targets cannot be considered playing significant role in dealing with the e-waste challenge in India.
Doesn't it sound familiar that there is an industrial lobby that is up against a law like this? Well, the extended producer responsibility or the EPR will be of no use unless there is a proper auditing and monitoring mechanism. So with this kind of scenario, is it all doom for electronic waste management in a country like India? Isn't there a consumer angle to this? Listen to Shalini as she talks about a platform, e-waste exchange. Is there something that an individual citizen or a common man can do to tackle this? Because the source of e-waste is at the consumer's end. What do you think the common man can do in a country like India to ensure that the impact is minimum?
Yes. So domestic sector is playing a very significant role because somewhere around 44 to 46% of electronic waste come from the domestic sector. And the e-waste management policy in India is not talking about this major chunk of the electronic waste. So what has happened, there are many different kind of players popping up which do not fall into the regulatory framework. And that's a little bit, again, a point of a concern. So responsible consumption of electronic products and citizens' duty are two keys to solve the e-waste pollution or e-pollution challenge. If citizens start realizing that giving their electronic waste to kabadiwalas is hazardous, and for them as well as for the environment, then they shall use the easy pathway for disposal. And that is what ewasteexchange.com is. We provide the facility of online disposal of electronic waste, and it is operating successfully in Hyderabad. We launched in Bangalore and Lucknow also this month. And also, in association with Smart Cities Mission from Government of India, we are collaborating with more cities to expand our services, especially to ease out the life for citizens and to provide them with e-waste and plastic pollution-free smart cities. After all, what citizens need? They need convenience. They need sustainable development in short and long term. They need economic benefits. And of course, the responsible citizens also need the assurance of the safe disposal. And this is what we provide at the doorstep of the citizens.
That's a really good initiative. That's a good business model. Can you expand on how you operate per se in different cities? You mentioned that you started in Hyderabad, you're doing it in Bangalore. What's your roadmap? What's your plan to spread across India, and how do you plan to operate in the space?
Yes, so we, as the citizen model, for the citizen model specifically, our plan is to move ahead along with the municipalities. And that's why Smart Cities Mission from Ministry of Urban Affairs, Urban and Housing Affairs, they preferred association with us. And we are moving to Smart Cities first. And signing MOUs with the municipalities is the first step that we take, because municipalities who are the one who are face-to-face to the citizens there in all particular city. And at the back end, of course, we provide our technology and our infrastructure for managing the electronic waste and plastic waste menace in different cities. And we are moreover using the strength of the technology for dealing with the pollution. And probably we can say that we are the first organization using Industry 4.0 for dealing with the waste management challenge in different cities. Of course, if within an year or two, you will see the larger scale impact, because whenever we move to any city, or I'll take an example of Hyderabad. Hyderabad population is about 1.2 crore. So our presence here in Hyderabad is impacting the population of around 1.2 crore, which of course for other two cities, the population is around 1 crore or so. So our impact footprint, if we just move to three cities, our impact is for around 3 crore citizens. And that's what the volume of impact I see. If we really move along with the Smart Cities Mission, our presence in about 100 cities with an average population of 80 lakh to 1.2 crores in every city. So we are trying to create an impact of about 100 crores on the population of 100 crores by providing them e-waste and plastic waste pollution-free smart cities.
Thanks, Shalini. That was really good to know about e-waste exchange plans in the near and long term. On a final note, do you have any tips that you can give to common man to ensure that they act responsibly in handling e-waste?
Yes, see, every segment in our society, either it's a common citizen who is also the professional at some end, because every citizen or educated person is either studying in a school, college, or they are working somewhere. So they know that the electronic waste and plastic waste challenge is too big, and India is at present is under capacity to solve this challenge. My message to the citizens and the businesses will be that be a responsible consumer of electronic products. There is a very easy method that online platforms are provided to you for direct channelization of electronic waste for safe recycling and resource recovery. So use that. And in addition, I would like to request the municipalities, especially because they are the one who are serving the citizens, that there are technologies available that can be adopted easily for solving the electronic waste management and related issues. So use that, bring that in place, be open to the innovation and the new practices. Thus, the problem can be solved, of course.
Well, that's rightly said. I'm sure the confluence of technology and the coming together of municipalities and the common citizens as essential to tackle this grand problem in India. So yeah, thanks. Thanks for taking time to come on the podcast and share more about what you do in this space. We definitely will look forward to more work, and we will look forward to have you back and when you share more stories from the work you have done. Thanks again.
Thank you, Girish. Thank you so much for inviting us. Thanks.
So Will, we heard Dr. Shalini Sharma talk about her platform, e-waste exchange. You might be wondering, why is this so important? Well, to put things in perspective, especially in a developing country like India, on one side, on the source side, there is a huge amount of electronic waste that is generated annually. But you might probably wonder that there is no one to recycle the waste. You are probably wrong. There are a lot of recyclers, registered recyclers in a country like India. And when you talk to the recyclers, they'll probably tell you that their plants are underutilized. So the problem lies in the channel, the medium that connects the consumers to the recyclers. This is where a platform like e-waste exchange comes in handy, because they connect to the consumers and they also connect to the government or the ministry or the local body that acts as a channel or conduit between the consumer and the recyclers. So a platform like this will definitely help ensure that the electronic waste is safely recycled and repurposed. So after listening to this podcast episode, I'm sure wherever you are, you'll probably look up to find if there is a channel like the e-waste exchange to make sure that you dispose the electronic waste the right way. I'm definitely sure that there are platforms like this that are available in every country and every major city. So the next time you dispose your electronic waste, be sure that you're doing it the right way. Now on to this week's action item towards Mission Shunya. So going with the flow of the conversation, I asked Dr. Shalini Sharma if she had any particular tip that she had to give to a consumer like you and me. And this is what she had to say.
As you asked about the citizen's responsibility, and I was saying that citizens are somehow the educated people and also the professional in their offices. We say, we the people build sustainable nation. So each of us is having a significant role to play. Either we are living in the urban habitats or we are into the rural areas. If we are educated, then we are having a responsibility to maintain the clean environment around us for ourselves as well as for the next generation. So I will say, please adopt the cleaner and greener methods for managing your waste.
So with that, it's a wrap on this podcast episode. Make sure you are subscribed to this podcast. The podcast is available on all major platforms like iTunes, Apple Podcasts, Google, Spotify, Stitcher, and many more. So the next episode will be live in a couple of weeks' time. So until then, you can join the conversation on the social media channels of Mission Shunya. The handle is @MissionShunya. And of course, you can always drop me an email, missionshunya@gmail.com. So until next time, signing off, this is Mission Shunya, towards a zero carbon economy.